In today's class, I have planned to discuss about a very important device which is known as AC generator. Generator means the one which is producing, generating. Look here, AC means alternating current. In our home, school building, offices, we prefer AC current, alternating current. And what is the difference between alternating current and direct current? We studied in class 10. What is alternating current? Alternating current is that changing current in which magnitude keep on changing and polarities are reversing periodically. I can show you the graph of AC current. This is the magnitude of the current keep on changing like this, and polarities are positive, negative, positive, negative. Polarities are reversing periodically. The magnitude of the current keep on changing and polarities are reversing periodically. It means after a fixed interval of time, a positive half cycle will become a negative half cycle, or a negative half cycle will become a positive half cycle after a fixed interval of time. In other words, how much time is taken by the positive cycle, the same time will be taken by the negative cycle. So that is the meaning of polarities are reversing periodically. Okay, but DC current is a direct current which contains only positive cycles, which has a repulsive nature, whereas this AC has attractive nature. In India, the frequency of AC current is 50 Hz. Whereas its root mean square voltage, RMS voltage, is 220 volt in India. But in America, its frequency is 60 Hz and RMS voltage is 112. This is in India. This is in America. 60 Hz and 110 volt. Why this difference? Higher the voltage, lesser the current, lesser would be the loss of power. If you take the power loss is equal to I square R. Higher the voltage, lesser the current. Lesser the current, lesser the loss of power in wires, in metallic wires. So the loss of wire will be less. So we prefer, we Indians prefer for loss of power, to reduce the loss of power. But in America, the voltage that they are using, the RMS voltage, that is 110 volt. Lesser the voltage, more the current. More the current, more the loss of power. Why? Why do they give preference for less voltage? Because lesser the voltage, lesser the dangerous, lesser the harmless, lesser the dangerous to the life. It is harmless. This 110 volt is less harmful to the human beings because it has less voltage. Okay, but here in India, voltage is high. Higher the voltage, higher will be the attractive nature. So therefore, it is more dangerous to human beings. It is more dangerous to the life. It is more dangerous to the animals.
But we Indians give less importance to the life, more importance to the loss of power. But in America, they give more importance to the life, less importance to the loss of power. That is the difference between India and America. Fine.
Okay, here the topic is AC generator, the device that generates electricity.
Yes, we use this AC generator in hydroelectric power station, in nuclear power station, in solar power station, in wind power plant, and so on. Why?
AC generator is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. As I have told you that this AC generator is used in nuclear power station, in atomic power station, in thermal power station, in solar power station, in wind power station, in hydropower station. So wherever the power is generated, electricity is generated, there this AC generator is installed. In nuclear power station, where the nuclear energy is converted into electrical energy, whereas in wind power station, wind energy is converted into electrical energy. In solar power station, solar energy is converted into electrical energy. In hydro power station, the kinetic energy of the water is converted into electrical energy. Okay, the aim of this device to build is to generate electricity. But the source is different. That may be wind energy, that may be water energy, that may be solar energy, that may be nuclear energy. But in all these conversion from one energy to electrical energy, water to electrical, wind to electrical, this AC generator is used. It's also called dynamo, AC dynamo. Okay, what is the principle of this AC generator? On what lines the AC generator works? AC generator works on the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. It works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. What is that electromagnetic induction? The magnetic field associated with the coil changes induced EMF is generated. The magnetic field associated with the coil changes induced EMF is generated. The induced EMF generated in the coil is proportional to rate of change of magnetic flux. So the principle of AC generator is very clear, that it works on electromagnetic induction. Okay, what is the rule involved in the generation of electricity by AC generator? The rule, it works on Fleming's right hand rule states that stretch the first three fingers of right hand mutually perpendicular to each other. Thumb finger shows the motion of the conductor or the motion of the coil. Forefinger shows the direction of magnetic field. Central finger shows the direction of induced current. I repeat, thumb shows the motion. Forefinger shows the direction of magnetic field. Central finger shows the direction of induced current. So, the induced current produced in the generator, whose direction is found by Fleming's right hand rule. AC generator basically it converts mechanical energy to electrical energy. What is the construction of AC generator? Let us see the construction of AC generator. A strong electromagnet is used. Which contains north and south pole. Okay? This is about the construction of AC generator. Okay, let me draw like this. We have a north pole and the south pole of a magnet. North and south pole of a magnet. And here is a rectangular coil. Here is a rectangular coil. It is connected to rings R1 and R2. Two rings are there. It's connected to rings. Here there is a carbon brush. Here is a ring R2 and there is a carbon brush here. B2, this is B1. Then B2 is connected to a load resistor RL and B1 is connected here. Okay. The same diagram I am going to draw here to show you the construction of AC generator. Here is a rectangular coil. It's a rectangular coil. The coil is kept in a magnetic field. North and south, a strong electromagnet is used. This is the ring R1. This is the ring R2. And here is a carbon brush B2. Here is carbon brush B1 connected to load resistor. Yes, this is the direction of magnetic field. And here this coil is connected to turbine. It is connected to turbine. When water falls here with a great kinetic energy, as we have seen in the dam, we have seen that where the water is stored, the stored water is allowed to pass through the pipe. Okay, when the water hits the turbine at the bottom of the dam, a turbine is kept at the bottom of the dam. Water falls from a great height onto the turbine. When the water falls, a great force is exerted on the turbine. The turbine starts rotating. When the turbine starts rotating, the coil rotates. When the coil rotates, then the magnetic field linked with the coil changes. Induced current is produced in the coil, according to Faraday. I repeat, from a great height, when water falls on the turbine, then turbine rotates. Turbine is directly connected to the coil. This coil is also called armature. So when the turbine rotates, armature rotates. When the armature rotates, the magnetic field linked with the armature changes. Induced current is generated. For every half rotation, the direction of the induced current changes. Suppose in the first half rotation, if the direction of the current is clockwise, in the next half rotation, the direction of the current will be anti-clockwise. Therefore, we get here this type of alternating current, that is negative, positive like that. That positive cycle is due to induced current in the first half rotation. This negative cycle is due to the direction of the induced current in the next half rotation. So like this, the armature keep on rotating. In every, suppose if it completes half rotation, the direction of the induced current is say clockwise. In the next half rotation, the direction of the induced current will be anti-clockwise. If you take the clockwise direction is a positive cycle, the anti-clockwise direction will be negative cycle. Therefore, such a current is called alternating current because it changes the direction. In one complete cycle, you will have a positive and a negative cycle. Right. Okay. As Faraday says that the induced current or the induced EMF in this AC generator is directly proportional to rate of change of magnetic flux. Faster the magnetic flux linked with the coil changes, larger would be the induced EMF. So induced EMF is equal to minus N into d phi by dt. Induced EMF depends on rate of change of magnetic flux. It also depends on the number of turns that are containing in the coil, that are available in the coil. Larger the number of turns, larger will be the induced EMF. If the coil contains only one turn, then it will have less induced EMF. If the coil contains 1000 turns, then induced EMF will be more, because the large magnetic flux linked with the coil changes, therefore large induced EMF is produced. Fine. So induced EMF depends on the number of turns that are available in the rectangular coil, and it also depends on how fast the magnetic flux changes which is linked with the coil. As we know that this flux is equal to BA cos B dot A. Flux is nothing but B dot A. B is the magnetic field here. A is the area of this coil. So B dot A is equal to BA cos theta. B dot A is equal to BA cos theta. Just like in 11th class we learned, A dot B is equal to AB cos theta. Here B dot A equal to BA cos theta. Here B is nothing but magnetic field, A is nothing but area. So theta is here the angle between the magnetic field, the direction of the magnetic field and the area vector. This is the direction of the magnetic field and the direction of the area vector. Suppose the direction of the area vector, if you take, which is area vector is always perpendicular to the plane. Area vector is always perpendicular to the plane. Suppose if you keep like this, okay, then area vector will be vertically downward and the direction of the magnetic field is like this. Therefore, area vector and the magnetic field will have 90 degrees. Fine. So like that when you rotate this, the angle between magnetic field and area vector keep on changing. When this coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field, that time the area vector and magnetic field are in the same direction. When the plane of the coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field, so that time the area vector and magnetic field direction is in the same direction, therefore angle will be zero. When the plane of the coil is parallel to the magnetic field, that time the angle between the area vector and magnetic field will be perpendicular. So as the plane of the coil changes, the angle between B and A changes. So here B, then if you substitute the value of theta, as we know that theta is nothing but angular displacement, that is angular velocity is equal to rate of change of angular displacement. In 11th class we learned angular displacement. Here suppose if you take the angular displacement to 0, then angular displacement will be 90 degree, then 180, then 270, 360. So as the coin rotates, the angular displacement changes from 0 to 360, 360 to 0, like that. So angular velocity, this velocity is called, the rate of change of angular displacement is called angular velocity. So angular velocity is rate of change of angular displacement, and then theta is equal to omega t, substitute here, you get this one. So if you give these values here, what you get? Minus n. Then phi is nothing but here, phi is nothing but BA cos omega t. BA cos of omega t, this is not good. BA cos omega t divided by dt. So this is equal. Okay, you take this omega somewhere here, right here. Omega is equal to theta by t, or theta is equal to omega. Then E is equal to what you get? Minus N. B is constant, magnetic field. A constant magnetic field is provided here by using electromagnet. And A is also constant. Area of this coil is constant. Area of the coil is constant. Then differentiation of cos theta is minus sin theta. Minus sin theta. Again, differentiation of omega t is omega. Differentiation of omega t, how it is omega? Keep omega is constant outside and you get dt by dt. Differentiation of t with respect to t is 1. So you get omega. You get omega. That's how omega has come here. Then E is equal to minus into minus plus. What you get is NPA omega, it's omega into sin omega t. This NPA omega is called maximum induced heat. That is called maximum induced heat. So that maximum induced heat, I can write it is E naught maximum peak, which is equal to NPA omega. So the equation takes, substitute the value of this NBA omega is E naught into sin of omega. What is N? Total number of turns in the coil. Number of turns in the coil. B, magnetic field in which the coil is rotated. A, area of this coil. Omega, angular velocity. So E naught is called maximum EMF. Peak EMF. So that we can see here by using that wave diagram. Is that out here? Fine. So we have this one here. Suppose if you put here omega t, this omega t, what you got here? This one. This is the equation. Let us draw the nature of graph. This omega t is nothing but theta. Is nothing but theta. Theta can be 0. Theta can be 90, 180, or 270, or 360. Okay. Sin 0 is 0. 0 into anything is 0. So EMF is 0. EMF is 0. Because omega t is theta. When you take theta equal to 0, sin 0 is 0, 0 into anything is 0, so E equal to 0, point is 0. If you take theta equal to 90 degree, sin 90 is 1, so this becomes 1. E naught into 1 is E naught, maximum. Here it comes. Then if you take 180, sine of 180 is again 0. 0 into anything is 0. So, 0. Here if you take 270, as you know that sine of 270 is minus 1. Minus 1 into E naught minus E naught. So it comes here. Sine of 360 is 0. Sine of 360, 0 into everything is 0. So it comes here. So you get the wave like this. This is called induced EMF. Here it is called maximum EMF. Here also it is maximum EMF. So this is all about the AC generator. What are we discussed here? AC generator is a device which converts mechanical energy to electrical energy. It works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. It works on the rule Fleming's right hand construction. It contains magnetic field, armature, rings, two rings are there, R1 and R2 are two rings, slip rings. They are used to change the direction of the current. For every half rotation, the direction of the current changes. To change the direction of the current, rings are used here. And these two are carbon brushes. V1 and V2 are carbon brushes. To get electrical contact between the outer circuit and the generator. Here is a load resistor. Whatever the current is induced here, it can be taken across the load resistor. So, to get electrical contact, carbon brushes are used. They are fixed, this coil rotates, ring rotates, but carbon brushes are fixed. So, to get electrical contact, carbon brushes are used. Okay, so this is about generator, AC generator. We can work out one numerical also. How much maximum induced EMF is produced? Suppose if this coil contains 100 turns, and the strength of the magnetic field, say for example, 0.01 Tesla, okay? Area of the coil is 10 raised to minus 2 meter square, okay? Then the angular velocity, suppose if this coil is rotated half revolutions per second, that is revolution per second means linear frequency, half revolution per second, that means every second only half revolution is completed. Suppose if you take this is a coil, this is called half rotation, half revolution in one second, 0.5 per second. So that is frequency. You can convert that frequency in terms of angular frequency q by mu, that is 2 pi into 0.5. So substitute the value of pi, that is 3.14 into 0.5 gives you omega. So you know omega. You know NBA and omega. You can substitute all these values in this formula. You can calculate the maximum EMF that is generated here. So this is all about AC generator. Thank you.